being on the stage, the amount of training we have had, you know, Sidney Poitier, I was very fortunate. In fact, he came I talked to him before that, but I think it was when we came to Soldiers Play. And he said, "You're good."
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and wow. I got a part in a movie in 1986. I called it The Nigger They Couldn't Kill.
Oh.
Yeah, he was supposed to be, he raped a white woman, and they tried to electrocute him, but it didn't work. And he became sort of a cult hero. No, not that one. That was the other awful one. But
yeah.
And then they tried to hang him, and they tried to do all this stuff. And I had a lot of training day in me. And there were some Jewish people in the audition, and I said, "Yeah." They said, "No, it's funny. It's like they hang them and then they can't." I said, "Yeah, like you bring some Jewish people into a room and they think it's a shower, but it's gas."
Oh.
And they said, "Right." I said, "Right. That ain't funny." Mm. So to me, it wasn't funny about putting a rope around my MF'ing neck either. I made a point. The guy was like, "Who the hell is this little nigga coming in talking like this?" So anyway, make a long story long. I called Sidney and I was sick because he told me to call him. I said, "Man, they offered me $600,000 to play the nigga they couldn't kill." And he said, "I'm not going to tell you what to do." He said, "I'm not going to tell you that, Denzel." He says, "But I can tell you this. The first two or three or four films you do in this business will dictate how you're perceived in this business."
Mm-hmm.
So you make a decision. You know, he didn't tell me what to do, and I give him credit for that. And I turned it down, and 6 months later, I got Cry Freedom and got an Oscar nomination. So it could have gone an entirely, you know, you never know.
Mm-hmm.
It could have gone, my whole career could have gone an entirely different way. Well, a different way.
Okay, yeah. Ms. Davis?
And all the Jewish people now, be nice. Just making a point. But I was dead serious about that, because they were laughing.
Everything.
Like, "Oh, no, it's funny. They electrocute him, and then I could just see the poster with me with a rope around my neck." You know, I just had dreams about it. Like,
I have a question.
That wacky guy they try to kill.
Mm-hmm.